The machine before us is a vertical plastic injection molding machine, making use of two-color injection molding. The die employed here is made to produce four parts simultaneously using a metal insert in which a number of holes retain the black plastic shell which is first injection molded. This is then inserted into the mold for the second shot, at which time white plastic rather than black, under extreme pressure and heat, is reduced to about the consistency of toothpaste. It is this white plastic which is forced through the die runners into the cavities in the parts, filling them with the white plastic, so that when the part is removed from the die, a homogeneous plastic molding surrounds the steel insert with white, everlasting numerals embedded in the black material. But our success story camera is leading us to an even more complex plastic operation. The machine we're about to view is called a dual injection plastic molding machine. We understand this is one of only three such machines of this particular type in existence in the world today. It's entirely automatic, producing the same operations you've just viewed by use of two colors of plastic simultaneously rather than in separate actions. Its value lies in producing parts which will undergo unusual usage in operation. Parts such as key tops, control knobs, and dials. Two dies close vertically, and the rams carrying the two-color plastics enter from each side. A carrier plate, operating in four different positions, indexes or controls the separate steps in this molding process. In the first and third positions, the contrasting colored plastics are injection molded. The second position is a cooling action, and the last action is called a stripping cycle. In about 19 seconds, this machine produces up to 20 individual parts. At this moment, it's turning out key tops for Frieden calculating machines. If the molding passes inspection, it's placed, complete with its runners, into an ingenious machine which shears the key tops from the runners. And as we can see now, the various keys are deposited by tubes into their appropriate boxes, according to their separate numbers, ready to move to the storeroom. It may be of interest to learn that this one machine and these molds represent an investment to Frieden of over $75,000. However, its extreme efficiency and improved product makes the investment an actual economy. You are viewing Success Story, an on-the-spot live telecast from selected locations in the greater San Francisco Bay Area, brought to you each week as a public service by Richfield, makers of RichLube HD motor oil and Richfield gasolines. Tonight's success story is originating at the San Leandro plant of the Frieden Calculating Machine Company, Incorporated. The average life expectancy of a Frieden calculator is many years. Consequently, the paint used on the covers must be of extremely high quality, long life and durability. And it must also be free of reflective glare. Frieden has developed what is called a wrinkle finish paint that more than meets all specifications. The method of painting the parts in itself is fascinating. This is called electrostatic spray painting. It's entirely automatic and handled on conveyors using special racks on which the parts are conveniently clipped. They move through a grid of wires which are positively charged with over 120,000 volts of direct electrical current. The final atomized paint then sprayed into this electrostatic field becomes charged. And since the parts passing through this field are grounded, the charged paint particles are attracted, much as lightning is attracted to a lightning rod. This assures an evenness of paint, controlled by the constant speed of the conveyor. The parts are dried in an infrared ray drying oven, which bakes on the prime coat. The final wrinkle finish is sprayed on under another electrostatic process, and then it's baked in the 65-foot infrared oven. Parts which do not undergo painting are plated in an ingenious, fully automatic cadmium plating machine. In this and other plating departments, various parts will be anodized or plated with silver, nickel, chrome, copper, and other metals, including gold. But back of all the technology, efficiency, and genius of production that we've witnessed tonight is the even more important element of direction and executive capacity, without which no industry can succeed. It is our very great privilege now to meet the president of this phenomenal success story that is the Frieden Calculating Machine Company, Mr. Walter S. Johnson, as he's interviewed by our reporter, Bob Day.
Mr. Johnson, I think one of the things that's impressed us a tremendous amount of during our visit to this plant is the tremendous size of it. Now, do you envision this as being the extent of Frieden's growth, or do you look to the future as one of continuing growth for the Frieden organization?
Oh, by all means, we expect to do a very considerable amount of growing. You see, this plant started here in 1938 with only 10,000 feet of square feet under roof. Today, we have 400,000 feet, and we've got 220,000 feet more building out here today. In addition to which, we have the plant in Holland that has 25,000 square feet, and we expect that plant to come to perhaps 100,000, 200,000 feet in the next 4 or 5 years. No, we're going to grow.
Yes, I guess you are. You know, I was looking at the large number of products here. What was the original product of the Frieden Company?
It was a rather simple model of an ordinary calculator, which ultimately we made into an automatic.